अब मैं माननीय संसदीय कार्य मंत्री श्री प्रहलाद जोशी जी के प्रस्ताव को सदन में मतदान के लिए रखता हूं। प्रश्न है कि यह सभा डॉक्टर निशिकांत दुबे सांसद द्वारा संसद सदस्य श्रीमती महुआ मोहत्रा के विरुद्ध सदन में प्रश्न पूछने के बदले नकदी में प्रत्यक्ष संलिप्तता के संबंध में दिनांक 15 अक्टूबर 2023 को दी गई शिकायत पर आचार संहिता की पहली रिपोर्ट पर विचार के उपरांत समिति के निरीक्षकों को स्वीकार करती है कि सांसद श्रीमती महुआ मित्रा का आचरण अनैतिक और संसद सदस्य के रूप में अशोभनीय है और इस कारण उनको लोकसभा सदस्य बने रहना उपयुक्त नहीं होगा, इसलिए संकल्प करती है कि उन्हें लोकसभा की सदस्यता से निष्कासित कर दिया जाए। जो सदस्य इस प्रस्ताव के पक्ष में हां कहें, जो विरोध में ना कहें, मेरे विचार में निर्णय हां वालों के पक्ष हुआ, हां वालों के पक्ष हुआ, प्रस्ताव स्वीकृत हुआ। सभा की कार्यवाही सोमवार दिनांक 11 दिसंबर 2023 को प्राप्त 11 बजे तक के लिए स्थगित की जाती है।
दिस लोकसभा हैज आल्सो सीन द वेपनाइजेशन ऑफ अ पार्लियामेंट्री कमेटी। Ironically, the Ethics Committee, which was set up to serve as a moral compass for members, instead it has been abused egregiously today to do exactly what it was never meant to do, which is to bulldoze the opposition and become another weapon to torpedo us into submission. This committee and this report has broken every rule in the book. In essence, you are finding me guilty of breaching a code of ethics that does not exist. The committee is punishing me for engaging in a practice that is routine, accepted and encouraged in the House. The findings are based solely on the written testimonies of two private citizens whose versions contradict each other in material terms, none of whom I was allowed to cross-examine. One of the two private citizens is my estranged partner who, with malafide intention, masqueraded as a common citizen in front of the committee. The two testimonies have been used to hang me there at polar opposites to each other. The complainant says I accepted cash in consideration from a businessman to ask questions in furtherance of his commercial interests. But the businessman's Suomoto affidavit says I pressurized him into uploading questions to further my agenda. The two are at polar opposites. The Ethics Committee, without getting to the root of this, has decided to hang me. It refused to summon the businessman to orally testify, and there is no evidence of any cash, of any gifts, anywhere. The recommendation of expulsion is based solely on the ground that I have shared my Lok Sabha portal login. There are no rules whatsoever to govern the sharing of logins. As the hearing of the Ethics Committee demonstrates, all of us MPs are conveyor belts to get questions from the public, from citizens, and to voice that in parliament. What is important is that if this Modi government thought that by shutting me up, they are going to do away with the Adani issue, let me tell you this, that this kangaroo court has only shown to the all of India that the haste and the abuse of due process you have used demonstrates how important Mr. Adani is to you and to what length you will go to harass a single woman MP into shutting her into submission. Tomorrow the CBI will be sent to my house. I'm sure they will harass me for the next 6 months. But I would like to ask, what about the 13,000 crore coal scam of Mr. Adani that the CBI and the ED have not found place to look at? You tell me I have compromised national security with a login portal? Mr. Adani is buying all our ports, all our airports, and his shareholders are foreign professional investors, and the Ministry of Home Affairs is giving them clearance to buy all our infrastructure. Ramesh Biduri stands up in Parliament and says to Danish Ali, he's one of 26 Muslim MPs, only one of 26. In a country of 200 million Muslims, the BJP has 303 MPs and has not sent one Muslim to Parliament. Ramesh Biduri stood up and told Danish Ali, no action has been taken. Nothing has been taken. You hate minorities. You hate women. You detest Nari Shakti. You cannot handle power and authority. I'm 49 years old. I will fight you for the next 30 years inside parliament, outside parliament, in the gutter, on the streets. Adim hang hingstro manobikotar jodi ami keu hoi, sojon harane shoshane toder chita ami tulboi. We will see the end of you. डू नॉट वंडर पंजाब सिंध गुजरात मराठा द्राविड उत्कल बंगो यू डोंट हैव द पंजाब सिंध इज नॉट आवर्स द्राविड इज नॉट योर्स उत्कल इज नॉट योर्स बंगो इज नॉट योर्स वेयर डू यू थिंक यू आर गोइंग टू रूल अस वेयर डू यू थिंक यू गेट दिस ब्रूट मेजोरिटी फ्रॉम द एथिक्स कमिटी हैज नो पावर टू एक्सपेल यू हैव अस्यूम्ड द पावर्स ऑफ अ क्वासी जुडिशियल अथॉरिटी एंड इम्पोज्ड अ पेनल्टी ऑन मी दैट यू हैव नो पावर टू डू You have disregarded due process, proportionality, and abused every tenant. This is the beginning of your end. Jab naash manush par chhata hai, to pehle vivek mar jata hai. We are going to come back and we are going to see the end of you. So thank you very much.
Today I am really sad to see the attitude of the BJP party. I don't understand. 557 pages, 495 pages report. সরি এটা বাংলাতেও কারেকশন একটু করে দেবেন 475 পেজেস রিপোর্ট জাস্ট সাবমিটেড টুডে অফ এথিক ইন দ্য নেম অফ সো কল বিজেপি মেজরিটি 90% ইন দ্য পার্লামেন্ট দে লে দ্য রিপোর্ট অ্যান্ড আফটার দ্যাট দে গেভ হাফ অ্যান আওয়ার টাইম টু অল দ্য পার্টি ইনক্লুডিং বিজেপি টু ডিসকাস দ্য ম্যাটার অ্যান্ড টু এক্সপেল মুনা মৈত্র আই ডোন্ট আন্ডারস্ট্যান্ড How the members will go through 495 pages within this half an hour and how all the speakers will take a decision. Today I congratulate the Indian Alliance, all they are together, we are united, they fight back and party fully supporting Mulla's case, she is elected by the people. And she belongs to women and young generation and for the all the community, caste, creed and everything. So how they betray and how they betray the democracy, how they betray the democratic rights, how they betray even the self-defense of the victims. They didn't allow Mulla to take her own stand to explain her situation without taking any justice. You have done full injustice. It's a democracy of constitution and rights. It is a betray to constitution and rights. They ditch the people, they ditch the parliament, they ditch the constitution because they have the majority. Today maybe they are in majority, but tomorrow they may not.